Hello, everyone. I hope all is well with each and every one of you. I stopped by to share a devastating testimony that I witnessed on last week. Listen, guys. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to my channel. This is Minister Nate. I greet you all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I pray everyone is having a wonderful, blessed day. I pray that everyone is doing well, everyone is feeling well. I pray blessings upon you, my brothers and sisters. I pray over you that the peace of the Lord, the peace of God will keep your heart and your mind in tune with Christ Jesus. Today I stop by just to share a few words of encouragement. I stop by to share an experience that I encountered on last week. I thank God for the power of the blood of Jesus. I thank God for his mercy. I thank God for his grace. I thank God for his love. Today, I just want to encourage a mother, a family member, a husband, a wife, a sister, a brother, aunt, an uncle, a cousin, a neighbor, a friend, to trust in the Lord, to know that God is faithful, to know that God is true, to know that his word says that he will never leave you nor forsake you. Disasters happen. Devastating things happen in this world. I've experienced devastation. I've experienced loss. But today I am just here to encourage you, my brothers and sisters, to know that you can trust God and know that you can take him at his word. The Bible says that heaven and earth will pass away, but not one jot, not one tittle of God's word would pass. He said we can remind him of his word and we can give him back his word, that healing is the children's bread, that he was wounded, that he was bruised, and the chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. He says that no good thing would he withhold from them that walk uprightly. He says the blessings of the Lord make it rich and add no sorrow with it. He said, if we seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, you see what I'm saying? There are laws and rules and principles that we must go by. He said in Deuteronomy 28, if we hearken diligently to the voice of the Lord, our God, to obey, to observe, and to do all his commandments, then these blessings, he will overtake us. Then he will bless us in the city and the field, and all of these blessings will come upon us. So I want us to know today that when you have a baby, that baby don't just get up and walk. That baby don't just start talking. That baby, it starts by crawling. It starts by saying dada mama. It starts by rolling. It, you know, it creeps. It don't just get up and start. We have to change it. We have to bathe it. We have to take care of it. We have to do everything for that baby. So that is how we should depend on our God, to take care of us, to supply all our needs. But when he say, don't do this, don't do that, don't go here, and don't, you know, we must hearken and we must be obedient. And I know sometimes we fall short, sometimes we mess up, sometimes things happen that, hey, but he said, if we confess our sins, that he is faithful and he is just to forgive us and cleanse us of all our sins and of all unrighteousness. So I encourage you today, my brothers, my sisters, I encourage you today as I encourage myself to trust in the Lord. As Proverbs tells us, lean not unto our own understanding, but in all our ways we must acknowledge him and he shall direct our path. We need God to direct our path. I shared a testimony of me. It's been 30 years now since I lost my daughter to a tornado. A tornado swept through, pick up the apartment we were living in and toss both of us into the ocean. And she died on impact. It took them at least 3-4 hours before they could have find her. She was floating under the rocks, but I was out in the ocean. So when I surfaced up to the top, I was able to hold on to a piece of debris from the apartment and wave and scream for persons on the shoreline that were looking for us, was able to see me, and two gentlemen came and rescued me. That was a devastating time in my life. That was a traumatizing time in my life, and I experienced something on August 1st of 2024. I got up that morning and I felt a little heavy in my spirit, so I knelt in my bed and I began to pray. And as I began to pray, I began to cry out to God and began to ask God for mercy, ask God for forgiveness, and I began to seek the Lord. I got up out of the bed and I went down on my floor, and I continued to pray and I continued to cry out to God. And all that day I was feeling a little heavy, a little weight. I had a nail appointment that I had to go to, and I was trying to book it up for 1-2 o'clock instead of going at 5:15. I was trying to get it, at an earlier time. But the lady never got back to me, so I went for the 5:15 appointment. And I want to just share this testimony and just share the mercy of God, and that no matter what we go through, that God is with us, and to trust in God. So I went for 5:15. I got my nails done, and I was finished about 6:30, 6:35, I left. And as I was heading back home to my house, I heard the Spirit said, ride down the road. Because the corner I live is like a T-junction, so I, needed to come straight up the hill to come to where I live. But I heard, go down the road, ride down the road. So I said, okay, I will ride down the road. In the back of my mind, I know they was having a reception at the community center that evening about 7 o'clock, and I didn't want to get caught down there because I wasn't dressed or anything like that. I just had on something to go to the nail tech. So I wasn't dressed. I hesitated whether I should go or not, but I heard the voice said, ride down the road. So I turned my signal and I ride down the road, and as I passed the community center, nobody was there. Thankfully, no one was there. So I said, okay, they ain't start yet, so that's good. So I continued to drive. And as I continued to drive, I noticed there was a few vehicles. A few vehicles well parked, like in the front of the school, on the side of the school. And I was like, nobody told me that they, there was a meeting, because they normally post, post a meeting or announce that there would be a meeting. I know they had a meeting prior, the day before. There was a public meeting for everybody to come out, and I wasn't able to make that meeting. So I was like, but I didn't hear that there was another meeting going on. So as I continued to drive past the school, I looked on my left and I noticed that there were a lot of persons standing up. And when I looked down on the ground, I noticed that there was a body of someone lying there. So I pull up in the car in the front of one of the minister's house that lived right there. And I jump out of the car, and as I jump out of the car, I went over to the scene and I lift my hands and I began to pray and I began to pray and I began to pray and I began to pray. And I was looking while I was praying, and I noticed that there were persons over this body, holding, over this body, just over this body, and persons were standing around and others were there. But I continued to pray, and the doctor came, and the doctor began to do CPR, and the doctor began to try to resuscitate the body. And the body was lying there lifeless, no life, no movement or anything. And I look at the hand and I notice blood was coming from the hand. The hand was like one way. Like when your hand break, it's like one way. And then the body was like there, but you could see that the head was like, like, it's hard to describe, but the body was lying there, but you could see the body was broken. because the way the hand was, the way it was laying there lifeless. And I continued to pray and I continued to pray. And the doctor doing resuscitation, trying to resuscitate. And after all of that, I heard, they gone. And when I heard they gone, I just began to pray and cry out to God for mercy. But I mean, the way the body was lying there was no life. But I believe that life is in Jesus Christ, hope is in Jesus Christ, victory is in Jesus Christ. And they took the body and they took it up to the medical office. And I fell on my knees in the middle of the road where all the debris was. And I began to cry out to God. And I began to pray and I began to cry out to God as cars pass, persons stand up around, persons crying, persons devastated. And my job was to pray. My assignment was to pray. And I prayed and I prayed and I prayed and I was on my knees and I was crying out to God. That soul may have already been gone, but there were persons who were there needed prayers, needed to hear a word of prayer, a word of encouragement, a word of upliftment, a word that will help them for the next hour, for the next day, for the next 24 hours. And I stayed on that ground and I began to pray. And I began to pray and I began to pray. And I got up after about 45 minutes or more. And there were some persons just there crying. I went and I put my hands around them and I said a word. And I went to the other two persons that were there. You could see they're devastated. And I put my arms around them and I say a prayer. And I managed to hop in my vehicle and I came back home. And while I was there on my knees praying in the middle of the road, my heart, my mind went back 30 years ago when I was pleading and begging for mercy, even though I know my child, it was 3-4 hours had passed and they still had not recovered her body. And when they did recover her body, she was already gone. But I say, by the grace of God, I am a testimony of the power of God, because I gave up. I thought I was gone. I was trapped. They told me for 27 minutes people were on the shorelines looking for me. And they couldn't find me. And while I was trapped to the bottom of the water, I said in my heart, I say, God, I try everything to surface out of that water and I cannot. I say, let your will be done. And the second I said, let your will be done, my hand literally shoot straight up out of the water and landed on a piece of the plywood from the apartment. I say today that I am a survivor. I am an overcomer. I encourage you, mother, today. Hurricane Debbie, I heard on the news in Florida, I think it was 5 persons. It's never easy to lose someone. It's never easy. But I just pray that as we as human beings, we as individuals, will seek the Lord, would make him our God, make him our Savior. The Bible says, weeping endure the night, but joy cometh in the morning. You might feel pain, you might feel hurt, you might feel broken and traumatized, but one day that pain will go. One day that sorrow, you will remember it, but it wouldn't be painful. You will think about it, but it wouldn't be painful. Excuse me, because the joy of the Lord, the peace of the Lord is upon your life because you surrender, because you give it to him. So I just stop by to encourage someone today. that no matter your pain, I know sometimes they can say, well, who are you to say? I've experienced the pain. I've experienced the loss, the devastating, the traumatized. I had nowhere to live. I lived under a garage for 18 months. I was basically almost homeless. But I thank God because he have my future. He know the thought he think towards me of good and not of evil. So I encourage you today to hold on to God, to trust in God today. Let him be your life. Let him be your benchmark. Let his word be your comfort. When mommy, when daddy, when sister, when brother, when husband, when and wife do not understand your pain and what you're going through, God, Jesus, he feels your pain. He feels your hurt. He feels your brokenness. And guys, it's been a week now. I think it's a week today. Yes, it's a week today. And the first 3-4 days, every time I went to bed and turned over, I would see that lifeless body lying there. And it would pain my heart. I felt pain. I felt hurt. I say, God, in your mercy, please forgive us. Please have mercy upon us. I feel the pain of our family members, of the co-workers. I felt the pain because I know that as I'm a mother, I'm a grandmother, I know what pain feels like. But God is my refuge and strength. He's a very present help in the time of trouble. Let God be your refuge. Let him be your strength. Let him be your joy. He loved us so much that he gave Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him shall not perish. God loved us so much with everlasting love. God. So I encourage you, mothers, families, husbands, wives, you going through something today. You don't have to go through it alone. Because Jesus is saying, cast every burden, cast every care upon him. Because he cares for you and he cares for me today. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, in all the pain, the hurt, the trauma, the devastation, lean on him. He will sustain you. He will strengthen you. He said, I will uphold you with the right hand of my righteousness, Isaiah 41 and 10. We have the word of God that will comfort us. He said, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Be strong. Know that God is with you. Know that he is your peace. When you wrestle in that night, when you feel confused and lost, God is your peace. He said, I will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee. I pray today, as you view this video, that your heart is encouraged, your spirit is uplift, because God is with you and God is with me. God is with us. We can trust him. We can depend on him. I saw that body and I toss and I turn and I cry. I cry for mercy. I cry that every individual that was standing there, those that were assisting with that body, all the bystanders, I pray that their mind will be shifted in a positive direction. Their heart will be changed. They will say, I surrender all to Jesus. Those that drive by in the car and look at the scene, that they would say, God, have mercy upon me. Forgive me, wash me, cleanse me. I'm a sinner. I need a savior. And that's you, Jesus Christ. Allow him in your heart. Confess your sins. Open up your heart and allow Jesus to come in. He's a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. I pray that you are encouraged today. It was hard. It is still hard being a mother and having to experience my personal experience. And I saw that body that ripped me. But God is faithful. And he is just. He knows our hour. He knows our time. He knows when our number is called. But will we be ready? Will we be ready? Will we hear, well done, good and faithful servants? Will we? I pray that your heart is ready, that when the Lord shall come or call, we all will hear, well done, good and faithful servant, as we seek him, as we trust in him, as we love on him, as we forgive one another, as we confess our sins. He said, if we regard iniquity in our heart, he will not hear us. But if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just. And if we have to go to a brother or sister or friend and say, I'm sorry, forgive me for what I said, for what I've done, let reconciliation be your portion today. Let forgiveness, let joy, let peace be yours today, as we all trust in God, as we all lean on our God, as we all depend on our God today. God bless you. I hope this video encouraged you. I hope you are blessed by it to make a decision that Jesus Christ would be your Lord and your Savior today. God bless you. God keep you. God strengthen you is my prayer in the name of Jesus. Peace and blessings to you, my brothers and sisters. Amen and amen.